prey, the acids of house. We promise you the future of house.
This is like big boom stuff. Everything goes quiet and then... Hey, there you go.
Nice.
Sounds something German.
Oh, I love that record.
What on earth is it? Oh my goodness.
We pray the acids.
And I do, I pray to the acid in house forever and ever. We worship in the church of our choice.
Sounds like a future, but it's not future. It sounds like future, but it's not.
It's not.
Jam unit or Walker, one of those.
It's not unit 700.
No.
That's one of my top five acid records of all time. So, Goosebumps. Brotherhood of Structure, Walker. They gave this record to me in the New Music Seminar in 1992.
Bang.
Ah, shit, yes. They're from Cologne.
structure.
I remember that synth line.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I know this shit.
At moments like this, the worst thing is that I am absolutely clueless, but I'm sure that somebody who's watching this is going to be going, it's this! How does he not know?
Good track.
It's on colored vinyl, I guess, on DJX or something like that.
Yeah.
No, I'm not gonna get this.
Ludovic Navarre.
Hexagon.
It's Hexagon on DJX, no?
Yes, Hexagon. Oh man, I should have known one. With a nice orange vinyl. I should have known that one.
Burning Trash Floor?
Burning Trash Floor. You're going really obscure. That's not a record that a lot of people know.
Never heard it before, man. Well, I probably might have heard it, but you know.
I hear this track, of course. Oh, wow, it's a good one.
Sounds like something Belgian.
Sounds kind of Belgian, definitely. But
I couldn't say what.
Yeah. Next one.
Go on. Put me out of my misery.
Cyber Psychos.
Okay.
Nothing.
I don't know the title, but it's Cyber Psychos by Asakirk. Yeah. Best acid record ever! Best one out of all of them!
Good one.
Oh, yes. Oh, this was a nice tune.
That would be Luke Viper, wouldn't it?
I don't know. Tell me.
Was it Mike Dread?
Mike Dread Macrocosm.
Oh, Mike Dread. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah.
This is a nice tune. I love this one.
In 1994, I played with Mike in Osnabrück for Azam Sharma and Axel Borch from Compact. There was no one in this party. We were both playing acid. People were giving us the middle finger. And he played this track. And when the acid pitches up on the ride from back from Osnabrück to Frankfurt Airport, that acid pitch was in my head the whole time. I couldn't get the track out of my head because I never heard of it before. It wasn't out yet. He had the test pressing from RNS or it was also on Reflex. And this record is like, damaged me. This is masterpiece.
I think I'm going to do some shopping on Discogs after.
If.
Of course I know this one. Yeah, of course.
Now we're talking.
And it was like really different acid from that time. And nobody was doing something crazy like this.
What a track.
This is his debut release on Seesaw Records. Tim is here from Rotterdam.
Okay, this does sound about right. So this would be like a Tim.
Yeah, this is like a Tim.
Like a Tim Dicker was.
They call him like a Tim because like is like a corpse. And he was always so white because he was only spending time in the studio. So they thought he was like a corpse, that he was like, you know, you look like that, you're so white. So that's where his name comes from, like a Tim. Like a dead guy, dead. Strange story, just not relevant to this track.
Oh, mierda. Of course I know this one.
Yeah, this is like, you know, US Midwest.
It's gotta be like something from Woody. No, I don't, it's not really ringing a bell.
Well, it would be Woody.
It's Woody?
And the DJ ESP.
That's Woody McBride, of course.
DJ ESP.
DJ ESP?
Yeah, I have the record.
Of course, DJ ESP.
What is the name of the track? Ladies and gentlemen, I have no idea.
I mean, like track titles. Man.
The track name.
It's gotta be the ESP, like Transporter.
I don't remember the title, like, oh, again.
But yeah, well, that's Woody McBride, right?
I still play this record occasionally, actually. If I'm asked to play an acid set, this one always comes out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, massive, really long breakdown in the middle.
Yeah, then you get, like, you know, the snares and the whole build-up. And then everyone's going, you know.
Da 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 da
I like their syncopation. The syncopation of their drums is usually quite nice, so yeah.
I'm so great in this game, I think I'm the winner, right?
Yeah, but it doesn't matter.
Something from the hardcore guys.
This is hard floor.
It's our floor.
Yeah, it sounds like a hard floor record.
Ah, floor, oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah, it's hard floor, I think, but yeah, thinking about the track.
Yeah, I don't know the track title, so.
Fish and chips or something like that?
Fish and chips!
Fish and chips!
Fish and chips.
Love this record. I really like the B-side as well, Mr. Anderson. That's another really good one. Yeah, classic record with a massive picture of really greasy fish and chips on the front.
Oh. Oh yeah.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, that's a cool tune. That's a cool tune. I like this.
It's good. Danza.
Yeah, that unique rhythm. Nobody has drums like him.
There's a kind of Italian influence there.
Anibaldi.
Leo Anibaldi.
Ah, mi piace Italy.
Maybe it's Leo Anibaldi?
Definitely Leo Anibaldi.
Mom.
I recognize the style. But again, a track name is difficult.
I don't remember. Fuck, so bad.
Well, I mean, same thing. I don't know the track title.
This is on the Possession 12-inch, the silver cover one. Oh, shit. I don't know the name of the track. Could be Possession.
Possession, wow. Yeah, sick.
Like the typical mid-90s acid stuff.
Nice.
I remember this break, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, nice one.
Probably from Holland or something.
Oh, this is a really good track. I really like this track.
Misha and Tim or something like that.
Misha and Tim.
Misha and Tim?
Misha and DJ Tim.
This is Misha, I like him.
It's not Access, it's not...
Trip It Out?
That's not this one. This is not their biggest hit, I think.
Purple Road?
Purple Road by DJ Mister and DJ Tim on Extracts Records.
Nice.
Yeah, it's like this long track that goes on and on.
How obscure are you going here?
Wow, that is really difficult.
It's this Dutch label, it's like a sub-label from Rurk. And they did a lot, it was distributed by Astral Music.
Nice one.
I don't recognize, but it's very good.
Nice track, yeah, yeah.
I think like it could be like one of those, what was that label, Touché, like Tatterbox Inhibitors of one of these records from that period, like 95-ish.
Yeah, of course. Oh, man. Yeah, you see, this is the thing that I was afraid of with this whole blind test. You know the track, you know who made it, and then you know, yeah, of course, Tatterbox Inhibitors. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Nice track, but I don't know the name.
Something with plastic something or plasmid. Plasmid, yeah.